jerseys.
What's up?
What's wrong?
Well, our baseball field is flooded. We have a game on Tuesday, 2 days from now, and we can't find another field. We're going to have to forfeit.
I'm sorry.
So, I tried to make my own field, right, on a non-flooded field, but my baseball diamond ended up looking like a baseball diamond, actually, not a square.
So, your problem was getting a nice right angle.
Right, and it was really tough to just do by eye.
Well, I mean, I have a protractor. We could try that.
Oh, yeah.
That would work great.
Angle.
Yeah, perfect. Okay.
Yeah.
Can you guys help?
Yeah.
All right, perfect. Let's go.
One.
Okay.
Yeah, just line it up. A little bit to the left. Lot more to the left. Back to the right, maybe. Run to your right. Run.
That didn't work at all.
I'm sorry. This is really... it's too small.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We need something much bigger.
Bigger,
yeah. Something that works on a larger scale.
Yeah. But...
maybe we can try GPS.
GPS use satellites.
Yeah.
Just some coordinates.
Yeah.
Alright,
yeah,
I mean, good thing we have
some
right here.
Okay, well...
Mine says you went 5 feet east, not 90 feet west.
Well, this didn't work.
This doesn't work.
This didn't work very well either. It's just too big. So much for the baseball game.
Guys, I think we can find the answer in Euclid.
Who's Euclid?
That guy.
Euclid, how are you gonna help us?
Don't you worry, guys. It's all in here. And in here. Let's get to a blackboard. What we need for your square is a right angle. And to get a right angle, the best way to start is to start with a circle. Draw a circle just like this, and then draw a diameter right through it. Now make a line starting from that diameter as long as you need it. It will be the side of your square, like this green line here. Now watch the blue line. It looks like a right angle, doesn't it? But let's see if we can actually prove that it's a right angle. I draw another radius of the circle. Now let's look at all the angles put together. We have two isosceles triangles here. I'm talking about the small triangles inside the big triangle. Now, the red angles are equal and the green angles are equal. One thing we know is that all the angles inside a triangle put together equal 180 degrees or two right angles. Now let's take a look at all our colorful angles put together. That's two right angles. But what we really need is just one right angle. So we will take only half of what we have. That is one green angle, one red angle. We have our right angle. But what we need to do is to separate from the blue line a line that is as long as the green. A circle can help with that. Again. Now draw a nice green line. Here are two sides of squares. Now, since we need all sides to be equal, let's make two more circles with the same radius as our green line. Where they meet is our final base. That looks like a third base to me.
Let's go try it outside.
Thank you.